I am going to be taking out the 2023 Ducati Panigale V2 Troy Bayliss edition. I'm going to take it out for the first time myself here. Should be a pretty good ride. The weather finally broke a little bit, and I'm excited to see exactly what this bad boy can do. So let's go ahead and turn it on for the first time. You guys will get to see it all happen as it happens. Oh wow, definitely sounds like a V-twin. Reminds me of the days back at the Suzuki TL1000R. For all of you guys that have ridden for a long time, you guys remember Suzuki's version of the sports bike? Wow, that's pretty cool. That is pretty cool, guys. I'll let her warm up for just a little bit. But, sounds great. That's a stock can too, guys. And like I had mentioned on the last video, I'm not going to upgrade. I'm just going to Bren tune it as is. But, should be very interesting to see how this thing performs. I'm just curious what it's going to do. So, let's go see. Let's look here to see how you look at the menu settings. So total 11 miles, guys. If we can see that, 109 degrees. I'll wait for it to get up to about 150 or 60. I haven't touched any settings, guys. Super, super stock. And I'm just gonna see how it feels. Then I'll go play with it a little bit later tonight once I kind of feel what's going on. But 11 miles, so we've got the up down on that side there. It should be good. I'm gonna keep it in sport mode too as I do the braking on it. I just will do it there, and then once we get it broken in, then we'll go into race mode after the 600 miles. But so far so good. I'm kind of, these tires are going to be pretty cool, I think. They're Corsa 2s. Obviously, you guys know they're already up to 4 right now. So they're kind of an older tire. But we'll see what kind of grip we get on them. About 131 right now. Let's wait for it to get to about 140. We'll roll. So should be kind of cool. Stands a little bit different. Ooh. Okay, let's figure out this clutch here. Ooh, this feels a little, wow. It's definitely in a, you're definitely in a race position, but it's a weird feeling. It's like it's upright, but it's not. Does that make any sense, guys? It's upright, but it's not. I don't have any tank pads in here too, so I'm gonna be very careful. My zipper does not scratch this tank. So I ain't gonna be barreling down the freeway like normal. It feels funny, guys. I'm gonna be very frank with you. It feels very different than my R1. Very different than my R1. So, let's see what she can do. Ooh, I gotta ease this clutch. This clutch is weird. All right, see how the quick shifter works. Ooh, smooth. Alright, Ducati. Let's see what you got. You guys, this bike is so much thinner feeling than a liter bike. I don't know why it feels that way, but it does. And Oh, I gotta use this. Okay, second. Ooh, neutral finds. You can find neutral very quickly on this bike. Unlike the Kawasaki, it doesn't have a freaking thing. It just has a notch in it. I like it. Huh, pretty wild. Pretty amazing. I need to get used to this clutch though. I'm gonna make some adjustments to it. It feels kind of far out there, which is a little weird to me. We'll see. We will see, guys. There's a first for everything. Just gotta figure this one out. One cycle at a time. I put a mile on it already, guys. Isn't that cool? 1 mile. I honestly don't know what the rev is supposed to be on this thing, but for the break-in, I'm just driving like I normally drive. Ooh, you know how they talk about the heat of a Ducati? I can already feel it under my right thigh. I haven't even been going more than 5 minutes already, guys. Temps at 169. This bike sounds so different. It's strange to me. I can tell you one thing. This bike is flickable. It just leans so nice. Let's see what the downshift feels like. Ooh, butter. Butter, my friends. You can tell the brake pads are brand new. Can't see nothing over this trailer. This bike is a lot quieter than my other bikes. I never use the rear brake, but the rear brake on this bike works really, really well. This clutch, I've got to get used to this clutch, my friends. It's a weird feeling clutch. Tell you right now, man, this whole thing about Ducatis being hot, my right thigh is on fire already. Well, this one's going to take a little bit of getting used to. It's definitely not an R1, I'll tell you that. So I've ridden an Aprilia RS60, 660, which was my other bike that I had, RSV4 factory, had that bike as well, liked it a lot. It'll be interesting to see what my level of love is going to be for this bike. Bike's at 216, 217. Get some freeway miles, get some air into the bike. I feel like this quick shifter, you really got to get up in the rev range to make it like super smooth. Feels really sturdy though, guys. I'll tell you, you know, not that it wouldn't, but it feels sturdy. It's very windy out here right now and the bike's not shifting or swaying. Steering wheel's extremely, obviously you can see the Ohlins steering dampener, it's holding. I'm only in fifth gear right now, about 5500 RPM. Engine temp's about 194 on the freeway so far. Air temp out here is around 80 some odd degrees, so we're about 82, 83. Interesting feel. It reminds me of my old Suzuki TL1000R. It's getting a sixth gear feel, it feels like. Smooth. The riding position on this bike feels good to me. I'm 5'10 and a half and it feels really comfortable. So good, my friends. In this thing so far. Guys, I'm just kind of just cruising with there at about 5,000 RPM, nothing crazy. Sixth gear. Typically at this speed on my R1, I'm only in third or fourth, just to give you some reference. Ride the bike a lot longer tomorrow. Just wanted to get a little bit of miles in here. Just get a feel for her. I'm liking this a lot though. Bike feels really solid. Might even say comfortable. downshifts on this thing are really nice. Really, really nice. Get too crazy on these corners here. Still got the wax in the tire for a little bit. Just the first 60 miles. Acceleration on the bike is very, very linear. Liking it so far, guys. Like it a lot. Temperature for engines about 189 cruising speed. Heat under my right thigh on a scale from 1 to 10, 10 being like hell, it's a 7. Definitely hot. I need to adjust the suspension for sure. exactly where I want to be, right behind a freaking rock truck. Flash, the bike does handle very well. I like it. Throttle response is great. Shifting is smooth. The naked bike across the on the other side of the freeway there, it looked like he was about to get blown off his bike. It's really windy right now. I don't know if it's just because the bike is new, obviously, and may have some sort of limiter on it currently as it breaks in, but I feel like I'm really having to turn my wrist to get the bike to go when I'm just so used to just barely cracking my wrist on the R1 or on the Kawasaki on the ZX10. This one I feel like I'm having to really turn my wrist to get the bike to go forward. Which is somewhat strange to me. You think this dude in front of me would get the hint? Too bad of a first ride, 37 miles or so. Sounds good coming down. Which is really, really nice. Utah. It's pretty nice, that bike. engine braking on this bike is excellent, actually. You could set it like one. Traffic is really bad right now. It's very warm right now. Light. That's a good thing. Quick shifter already seems to be working so much better. I'm also getting a better handle on throttle control for the bike, because I'm finding also too that the quick shifter works a lot better when you're actually progressing your throttle position. Guys, I really like this bike. Gosh. Once I get the suspension adjusted too, this thing's gonna be butter. It will be butter. Learning curve is really small or short on this bike, guys. I feel like I know her a little bit better. I feel like I could ride them a lot harder the next time. As he brakes in. Hopefully the microphone picks up, you know, the V-twin, the growl from the V-twin. I've got earplugs in, guys, obviously, so it sounds really quiet to me compared to my other bikes. My other bikes are super, super loud. And even with earplugs in, it sounds like I don't have earplugs in. My other exhausts. But hey, that was not a bad inaugural ride, my friends. Thank you for coming along with me on the journey. Okay, gotta get used to this kickstand. Is weird. There's no hook on it. But wow, I will take that. Pretty cool. First ride, we put 41 miles total, guys, onto the bike. I will definitely take it. What a beautiful machine. Excited to take it out for an even longer ride. But yeah, comfortable. I'm not hurting at all, guys. Anyway, love you guys. CK out. I just turned the bike off. The fan is still running. I guess all this because the bike was super, super hot, but I've never had a bike where the fan kind of ran after you turned it off. It's in complete off position too. Definitely smells like a new bike. You know, and it's like just burning off whatever it's burning off. Wow. Guys, if you like this ride, please subscribe, like, and tell all your friends about it and follow, guys. Appreciate y'all. You guys have a great day. Cheers.